Using shortcuts for copy and replace, as well as for shifting pitches in Melodyne, feels a bit like step sequencing your synth or bass patterns. Like in my example today, where I started a song idea with a few chords and drums and pads, and I want to add a small sample of a bass to it. Okay, before we make that fit, let's do some preparations. Open the chord track. With a right-click, get the chords from the DAW. Switch the background to chord scale, suggesting white backgrounds for pitches that will work with the composition and gray ones for pitches that might not be a good idea. Actually, today I would prefer to see less white options, so go back in there and narrow down the choices. And one more, set the snap to chords as well. In my DAW here, the duplicates are still connected, so moving one note will also change all its repetitions. So that's not what I want today, therefore I select all duplicates and make them become independent from each other. In most other DAWs, this is the standard behavior anyway. Okay, now we are set for creating a new bass line, and I will use a lot of key commands for that. For example, to move notes to the various white suggestions. Here the chord track tells me to go for a C. Next chord would be A. The F is already there, so let's step to the chord after that, selecting all notes and bring them to D. And of course you can combine mouse actions like rubber band selection with the key commands for altering the pitch. Let's listen back to what we have so far. This definitely needs more variations, but I guess by now you already know how to create those. First, allow for more options again, then make some nice moves. Do similar stuff in other bars, and after a while you may have something like this. Also a good idea, mute a few notes here or there, take the amplitude tool for that and double click, or select a few notes, use this option from the right click menu, and combine this with muting. And finally, varying the length of notes also helps a lot. Of course, you can do this manually by deleting one note, and then altering the length of the note before that. But there's a quicker way of doing that, and this again is using copy and replace. First, select a note and press copy. Now, shift click to select the following note as well, and press paste. Did you get that? Let me do it again. The copied note is a short one. By selecting a range of two notes before pasting, you define a longer range, and upon pasting then, the originally shorter notes get stretched so that it fills this longer space. Of course, this works with more than just two notes as well. Okay, I hope you found some inspiration in today's video, and that there are a few things now that you want to try out for yourself the next time you work with Melodyne. Thanks for watching. Bye.